good morning, everyone, and welcome back over here to the Magic Kingdom. We decided to come on over today because here with my family, Kayla, we're gonna have a really good day. We're also meeting up with some friends today as well, but it's just really exciting. I haven't been to the Magic Kingdom since the new year started. Actually, I haven't been to the Magic Kingdom in a while, actually, so I'm really stinking excited to be back here. Let's ride some rides, see all the stuff, maybe see if the People Mover is running, maybe? Not sure yet. Still working, still under refurbishment, and see some Tron construction, so it's gonna be a really great day here at the Magic Kingdom. I can tell you what, we did not get the very best weather for today. It is very gloomy and gross and disgusting out. But look at all the work they're doing on the train station though. Now, that sounds like they are doing some repair work and cleaning, but they're also adding all the gold tint to it because of all the stuff coming in. So, it's gonna be really exciting though once it does get finished with that. So what is pretty cool actually is that the park doesn't open till 9 today, but we were able to get in a little bit earlier because what they've been doing is they've been opening the park just a tad bit earlier, and they have only 6 attractions are running right now. So like Space Mountain, Big Thunder Mountain, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, Big Thunder Mountain, and Splash Mountain, and one other attraction I think is running already to help with like dispersing people throughout the park already so that you're not waiting in a whole lot of lines and congregating. It's kind of what they're doing. But also the sad thing is all the Christmas decoration are officially down. The other thing also is kind of a little bit of a downer is that the Sorcerers of the Magic Kingdom will be ending very soon. I can't remember the exact date for it, but it will be ending, so they will not be doing that anymore throughout the Magic Kingdom. Now, that may mean they may be doing something different, maybe doing something new, but no word yet on that. And walking right down Main Street up to the Cinderella's Castle. Still a very gloomy day out, but it's not as foggy as it was earlier today. Like earlier when we were coming in, it was very foggy, but it's also a lot cooler today because there's a lot of cloud cover and there's a chance of rain all day. But it really pops out, like that paint job really pops out on like this like darker, on the cloudier spot. But then when the sun's out, it hits differently because it hits all that gold and makes it really pop too. We're actually gonna make our first stop into the Adventureland section. Normally one of my normal things was always to go to the right to Tomorrowland. But we are currently just working our way in to see if anything's open. Maybe do like either Jungle Cruise or maybe Pirates of the Caribbean, maybe head over to Frontierland and do Big Thunder or Splash while it's still not quite as busy. I think our first ride of the morning is actually going to be, we're going to go ahead and jump onto Pirates of the Caribbean before we head into Frontierland to try to do Big Thunder Mountain. This is a good time of day to come because it gets early enough in the morning that everyone's still getting around to all the attractions. So it's easier to get onto these rides before they get super busy. This has got probably the best theming out of any attraction at Disney. It feels like you're literally walking into like a battleship or like a fort, heading off into a boat to go into the middle of the freaking pirates doing what they do best, pillaging a village.
Oh, my God.
It looks like Splash is starting to run actually now, but it looks like that they're just doing their testing this morning because it was a little bit, not, it was, as I say, delayed open this morning. But that's also just whenever it does go through the refurb and transfer over to Princess and the Frog, I think they're going to upgrade some things to try to like put a good work into it, make sure it's more reliable. So Rivers America is still down right now for some refurbishment, but what's really getting me is that it's not only empty, but there are actual cars in there. But you see they've got a lot of scaffolding going on. You see they're working over in that area, so needs a lot of work. So they're really going to be doing a lot of work on it. So that's a good sign, though, that they're putting some time and effort into it to try to make sure it's ready for the 50th. So really, I don't think we could time that any better. Splash Mountain, we were in line for Big Thunder, and Splash Mountain just opened, and it's got no wait right now. So we actually got a return time for Big Thunder Mountain, and we're going to go jump on to Splash really quick, since it's got no line right now.
Looking for a laughing place, they say. Looking for trouble, if you ask me.
This is real.
So we are done with Splash Mountain, and it is time to go back to do our return time for Big Thunder Mountain. So we're going to go ahead and do that really quick. But it's kind of fun thing is that, so if the line for Big Thunder gets super long, and you see the markers are down here, it actually can go up through the train station and then back around this way to help with the lines getting longer.
Awesome.
So it's about, let's see what time is it? It is 10:21 right now, and we actually got over to Frontierland around 10 o'clock, and we're already done with Big Thunder Mountain, Splash Mountain, and Pirates of the Caribbean. So really kind of moving along. And also it looked like that Peter Pan's flight was only a 15-minute wait. The longest wait in the park, of course, is Seven Dwarfs Mine Train at like 60, 65 minutes last time I checked. But also I think because it is a little bit more of a cloudy day, it's a little not like as picture perfect as one would say. Maybe that's why it's not as busy, but kind of keep track of the wait times throughout the day. Yeah, it looks like they're doing a lot of work over here. Some more like rock work, some painting on this, like on the, where the wheel is over here and everything else. So, I mean, I think they're just trying to clean everything up for the, as we get ready towards, as we get closer towards the 50th anniversary, and just make everything look clean and pretty. I mean, probably add more gold to everything because that's what you do, but I still just can't get over the fact that the it's drained so far down that you can actually like, that you actually have like cars driving on it. And it looks like they're even replacing some of the decking over there too. You see they're replacing some of the decking right there. So that's good. That's a cool sign though. I mean, the fact that they're putting all the time and effort and money into making sure it's done correctly. It's definitely a good day to come out though to the Magic Kingdom. It is very, very slow. There's not very many people walking around. It's 10 o'clock. Park's been open for only about an hour and a half though, but I think the weather is causing some people not to hang around as much. So we're actually gonna do, so we're actually gonna head up into Fantasyland, have, still get a return time for Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, and then maybe wait for Peter Pan's flight, and then for Haunted Mansion. Then just kind of walking back behind the castle into the carousel. The one thing that always makes me laugh is now the carousel always has a super long line, because they like go every other row with the horses. So it makes the line super long. Some days I've seen the line upwards of 20 to 35 minutes for just the Prince Regal's carousel. It's not too bad for Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, only a 45 minute wait. Usually when we first walked in, it was already posting an hour, but now it's only down to 45s. Just the fact that there's just so little crowds right now. I know this usually this time of the year is always the slowest point. So yeah, it's not, but it's just not seeing it kind of busy. It's kind of weird still, because even when it wasn't, like even when January came last year, it was still kind of busy. And the fact you see like Peter Pan's flight at only 15 minutes, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train only 45, also shows the difference of what having no Fast Pass can do as well. So even though the line is up and around, there's no Fast Pass coming in, so they're not having to stop every couple of parties to let Fast Pass go through. So it makes the line move way faster. So I think we're gonna go ahead and jump actually into Peter Pan's line, because the line is getting quite long right now. So we're gonna go ahead and jump in line, because it's only 15 minutes, but we have a little bit of time to kill before we get back for our Seven Dwarfs Mine Train return time. So this is one of the rides that has gone back in Magic Kingdom, has gone back to loading every single row. It's about 10 minutes right now, so that's actually not bad, actually. So, because before they were putting gaps in between all of them to try to social distance, but from what it sounds like, it's because of the fact that the buggies kind of go up and over you. You don't need to worry about like being socially distanced because there's not high enough back on them. So we'll see actually if it is 10 minutes. Also, the big difference also is that they are not doing the like pre-show thing. So when you walk in, you walk straight in and you have to just walk through the like the stretch halls. It's a little bit weird to do that because I'm not used to that at all. So I'm used to always this being very crowded with people. So walking in and not seeing hardly anyone is definitely different. I still love the one thing that people don't realize is that in the cemetery, up in the very back, is Mr. Toad, because Mr. Toad used to have a ride here. It's actually where Winnie the Pooh is now. So they always have the, so they always put that in there to kind of remember that. And it's time for us to come back and do our Seven Dwarfs Mine Train return time, so it'd be nice to do. We waited a little bit for this.
Yeah, that was so slow. Whoa!
Thank you.
I've kind of found a small issue I've got. So apparently when we ran on Splash, got a little bit of water in the camera. As you can see, it's kind of blurred around the sides. So I don't know how much more recording I'm gonna be able to do, because at some point I'm gonna have to figure out how to get this water out. So it's not on the lens, it's actually underneath the lens. And so you can see how it's kind of made it think. But if I like zoom it in just a little bit, you can see it kind of gets a little bit better. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to, I'm gonna have to probably take this camera in now to get worked on, but yeah, that's a, did not realize I did that on Splash. Yeah, it just seems to be like, as it's no longer records, the more it just kind of affects it. So I'll try to record as much as I can still, but unfortunately there's gonna be some little bit of issues around the edge. Also, I don't remember these trees being this big. I don't think I've been back here in a long time. So the trees are a lot bigger than I feel like they have been. So yeah, just unfortunately, I think the case is today, the camera is probably gonna be out of commission the rest of the day. So it looks like just riding through on space, it's kind of helped the camera with the water. The water's still in there. You can see a little bit, but it looks like it's getting a little bit better. So I've not been using it as much. The weird glare, there's kind of a weird fuzziness. So I'll try to use it as much as I can. I just really want to show you guys, it is very slow today. Like when I say it's slow, it's very slow. So Space Mountain right now has only a 15 minute wait to go in, and there's no line out here. And pretty much it was just walking right on. They do seem to be not loading every seat right now. So unfortunately that's still kind of going on, that they're not loading every seat. But that's kind of cool, like see, like, you know, middle of the week, Wednesday, there's no wait for Space Mountain. Also, it does look like that the People Mover is currently not doing any running at all today, so unfortunately it looks like that there's no opportunity to even try to ride it today, unfortunately. But I mean, they're still doing work, which means they are putting money and time into trying to make sure it's actually ready for people to ride it again, hopefully by the 50th. Well, looks like Buzz Lightyear is also another one of those shorter waits, because it's only like a 10 minute wait. And there's not even a line for it. So I think we're going to jump into this line and do this really quick. So because it is very slow, and also there's something unique that we haven't had a chance to try, is that the Tomorrowland Terrace is now reopened, where they're serving the food from the Columbian Harbor House. So we went ahead and mobile ordered, because you have to mobile order at the for the Tomorrowland Terrace. So we went ahead and mobile ordered, and we got kind of a mishmash of stuff. So plus, also, it just seems like that it's getting colder as the day goes on. So that may be helping with keeping the crowd levels down right now. Also, if you are wondering, the left floor is still closed. You know, there is a queue lineup built right here. This is actually for the Buzz Lightyear line, for the Buzz Lightyear line when it gets really long. So yeah, it's definitely getting a little more cloudy, a little more colder. It feels like it's gonna rain at any minute though. But I feel like that's Florida in general. So I was bad about this and didn't show our food, but what I wanna show you guys is quickly the menu they have to offer here. And so like they have lobster rolls, a trio platter, and if this can't be seen very well, I don't want to zoom in because I don't want to show there's no more water in this. But they have combo platters. So you can get fried shrimp, fish, and chicken nuggets. You can get with hush puppies and a choice of French fries or cutie mandarins. This is actually really good. Like the hush puppies are really good. I mean, it's just frozen food. So, but you can get some ice cream, a Minnie Mouse chocolate chip lava cookie, some just yogurt. So this is usually open from 11 to 4 most days during the week. So the big thing is that, so yes, this stuff is from Columbian Harbor House, but Columbian Harbor House is still not open back up yet, because right now it is being used for the extended queue for Peter Pan's flight. So that's kind of a big thing about what's going on with that, is because of the fact it's being used for the line, they can't open up. So they brought a lot of that stuff over here, mostly a lot of the fried stuff over here, but at least something kind of give you like something on Columbian Harbor House. So as we're kind of heading out, because we're going to stop up to Starbucks to get something on the way out, but it definitely does feel like it is getting a lot colder though. Like it feels like it's just been getting colder since we got here. So, but I mean, crowd level wise though, it's been very, very, very minimal. And I think it's been really nice because we don't get a lot of stuff done. Like I know you guys kind of, there's a point where there's a break because I couldn't use you guys. Even right now, I shouldn't be using it, but it's not as bad. Hopefully when I get home later, it may be able to fix it. So, but yeah, like even once you walk down Main Street, it's not that bad. So even though you have the marching band coming right down the middle, there's still like no one on Main Street. Like this is the emptiest I've ever seen. I think the last time I saw this empty was right before a couple of the hurricanes. But it is so barren down Main Street. It's kind of weird.